All right, Happy New Year to everybody here, and we have some news for you in 2014 and another great interview on Windows Azure. So first off, we have Microsoft Dynamics CRM announcement with combining with Paracher, a partner that we have, and we are now going to be integrating that into the Microsoft Dynamics suite. It's going to be really good to help out with integrating interactions with customers across a number of different channels. So definitely check that out if you are interested in the Dynamics CRM world. Next, the last three announcements I have are related to new Microsoft Virtual Academy courses. One of those is what's new in Windows 8.1 security. For those of you who are thinking about deploying new clients, Windows 8.1 has a ton of new enhancements for IT professionals and enterprise. One of those is security. If you want to get details on that, check out this course on the Microsoft Virtual Academy. Next up, we also have what's new in VDI for Windows 2012 R2 and 8.1. There's a number of new enhancements there. And I know like one of the things that I like, for instance, is the automatic resize. For instance, if you use Windows Remote Desktop and connect up to a 2012 R2 server from an 8.1 machine, it'll automatically dynamically resize your screen, even if you transfer it to a different monitor, right? And you don't have to disconnect and reconnect. That's kind of nice. So a little tip for you there. Another thing is a new course for Microsoft Virtual Academy, System Center 2012 R2, ITIL for IT Pros. For those of you who are not familiar with ITIL, it's a great foundation for learning the kind of fundamentals of different processes to kind of help enhance and streamline the processes inside of your business. Well, System Center 2012 R2 has a number of things that can help you out with that ITIL process, and this Microsoft Virtual Academy course will definitely educate you quite a bit on all those different areas of the ITIL process standard and how System Center can help you out with that. That's all for the news, and stay tuned for the Windows Azure Traffic Manager interview now. All right, welcome here, and I am joined today by NK. Welcome, NK.
Thank you.
Yeah. So we recently had the general availability of Traffic Manager.
Yep.
And I think it's a really cool technology, and that's why I'm bringing you in here. I'm hoping that you could tell us a little bit about Traffic Manager and what it's all about.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. So Traffic Manager is one of the key infrastructure components in Azure that we were previewing for a long time, for nearly a couple of years now. Mm-hmm. So last November, we went GA, made sure that it's battle ready. And now we got around like 3,000 plus customers already using it, jumping on it, right?
Yeah.
With very high volume DNS queries to the tune of 35 million queries per day, you know, per second per day is what we are seeing.
Wow.
So it's pretty compelling service.
Okay.
It's one of the ways to achieve the cloud scale performance as well as disaster recovery and the ability to kind of update your cloud services without taking any downtime. You know, this can be done across geo. You know?
Yeah.
So that is a compelling value that Windows Azure Traffic Manager brings.
Yeah, if you want to have a truly global service, you want to have that high redundancy availability, you know, there's a lot of options here in Traffic Manager. Yeah. So for the IT folks out there, or anybody who's in operations who wants to scale their their service, you probably are going to come to Windows Azure Traffic Manager. So.
Yeah.
But you know, without further ado, I mean, I'd love to see kind of this in action on how it works, and so maybe could you show me one of the first scenarios that you have there?
Yeah, sure. So like I said, Traffic Manager is a DNS-based service.
Yep.
Think of Traffic Manager as a policy enforcer on top of the DNS to kind of smartly guide the queries to the right set of your services.
Okay.
Right. So let me show a demo that shows how we will improve the performance, the web loading, and the ability for the user experience in terms of the ping time to your service.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. So obviously, if you have a cloud service in one data center and you've got users all around the world, I mean, it's better to obviously have
to route it
to the nearest service if
Absolutely.
You've got multiple services possibly in different data centers around the world. Yep.
Yeah. So for the demo setup, we are running two services. You know, one in East US, and one in North Europe.
Okay.
And the way we are going to demonstrate is we will create traffic manager policy for the performance, you know, as a first demo.
Yep.
So let me jump back into the demo directly. Right?
Yep, sure, yeah, let's do it.
Minimize this. So this is a very familiar managed portal. So if you, on your right, left-hand pane, you know, you, if you see this, you can see the traffic manager sign. Let me kind of home on to that quickly. Yeah, it's here, and which opens up the familiar traffic manager dashboard.
Yeah.
Here, it'll allow you to create a profile. Let me create a profile using a quick create option, you know, which will be easiest to do, actually.
Sure.
And let's, since it is the edge demo, I'm going to call it as edge performance demo of the Windows Azure Traffic Manager.
Okay.
And this is my subscription that I'm using called Gareth. Gareth is actually happens to be my program manager in Dublin.
Oh, okay.
I'm just hijacking
the
service.
There you go.
And you can see that the load balancing method chosen is performance.
Okay.
Like I said, there are multiple policies that you can use: performance, round robin, and failover.
Okay.
We are going to use performance for this particular demo.
Okay.
Then click on create. So as easy as that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you can see that HPerf is being created. If you click on that, you are going to go to the dashboard. Of course, you can read at your spare time all the all about traffic management details.
But you're the expert. You're going to show us it right now.
All right. We are going to dive into the nuts and bolts of the traffic manager here, right? So what I'm actually doing is creating the profile. And if you click on the endpoint, you are going to see a pointer to the add endpoints.
Mm-hmm.
Currently, it doesn't have any endpoints to monitor and direct the traffic to, right?
Okay.
So you need to first provision the endpoints.
Okay.
How do you do that? You know, you got a pull-down menu. So for this demo, like I said, we created two services. It's a simple .NET task pages. So one is called Demo US Cloud App Net. So I chose that.
Yep.
And then the other one is Demo US Europe, rather Demo Cloud App Europe. So let me search.
It's one right above it, I believe.
Correct. This is the one. Okay.
Yeah.
So this one is North Europe based, as you can see here, and there is the East US.
Yep.
Right. So let's get these two services being monitored by the traffic manager profile, performance profile.
Okay. Now the subscriptions that you're allowed to the endpoints you're allowed to choose from, is that across multiple subscriptions, perhaps just whatever that person that's logged into the management console has access to, or is it only a single subscription?
Currently, it's under single subscription,
okay.
But in future, you can expect, currently, it's even cloud services, right? It
okay.
doesn't take into account the websites and all,
okay.
like Antares, for example. But we are in the process of enabling you to monitor those endpoints as well.
Okay. Okay, all right.
So that's, stay tuned for those
okay.
features, right?
Okay.
So as you can see, you know, it's checking the endpoint and ensuring that, you know, endpoints are reachable, et cetera,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
So let's go ahead and do the configuration of this particular policy. There are certain things that you can tweak. First thing is the DNS time to live. You know, as you guys know, DNS time to live is, you know, how long a particular name is cached at the client.
Yep.
Right. You can tune it anywhere between 30 seconds to 300 seconds.
Okay.
So I'm going to choose 30 because, you know, the demo has to be agile a little bit. Right.
Right.
So I'm
right.
going to let me choose this.
So that right. 300, how did we come up with that number?
This is the standard DNS TTL that we generally use. So
it's kind of an something. Industry best
it's,
practice.
It's exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I chose 30 seconds as the DNS time for this particular profile.
Yep.
And the load balancing method is again performance. And traffic manager itself can use either HTTP or HTTPS for probing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it what actually it does is it probes the endpoints, right,
mm-hmm.
by sending the heartbeat messages.
Yep.
It can be either HTTP or HTTPS. So let's leave it at the HTTP and the port 80.
And that just looks for like a 404
exactly,
or like a,
yeah.
okay.
So it's,
yeah.
Yeah. So with that, I think we can save the profile. Now I'm saving whatever changes I made
okay.
into the system.
Yep.
Then let's go back and then check how we are looking in terms of the endpoints again. It should be ready for use, right?
Yeah.
So you got demo Europe Cloud App Net and demo US Cloud App Net, right? Mm-hmm. And you also have the way the we are going to access this is using Edge Perf TrafficManager.net.
Okay.
Now let me kind of tell you, you know, how the user is going to use this.
Yeah.
They're going to take this domain name. They're going to use it as an alias name, CNAME, you know, for their website. For example, contoso.com.
Yep.
Contoso.com will be pointing to this actually.
Okay.
And this particular TrafficManager.net is an intern pointing to your two services that we talked about.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. So now, based on the policy, the traffic manager is going to apply certain rules, right? In this case, it is a perf policy,
right,
which is the nearest service location capability. Okay, so let's go back and ping using a browser, right, for the traffic manager name. I'm not I'm not registering this traffic manager name today.
Okay.
But you need a third-party DNS hoster to do that.
Well, yeah, obviously, yeah. Somebody's got to have their own domain name. For now, I think people can use just the, the Edge Traffic Manager domain name. Yep.
Yeah. Absolutely. So let's let me use this Edge Perf dot Traffic Manager dot net. Remember that we are in US, so we should be able to go to the US web page.
Okay.
Right.
Yep.
Now, to simulate a Europe client, I also created a VM. If I go back to this Azure managed portal, I'll show you that we got a bunch of VMs, and then one of the VMs I'm going to log remotely into. Okay, so one of the VMs is called demo Edge VM rather. I pre-created it because it's going to take some time.
So North Europe. Yep.
And then the location is in North Europe, right? So let's RDP into that web page here, which is remoted through RDP into my North Europe website, rather VM.
Yeah.
So let's ping the same domain name, which is the traffic manager domain name, which is Edge Perf dot traffic manager.net. Remember that it would have been like contoso.com.
Right.
So
there it's in Europe.
There you go. Bingo.
Okay. And so that's doing it in this way because the performance profile, right, it's automatically detecting what the latency going to wherever it's at.
Exactly.
Okay.
So we have a sophisticated algorithm behind it. We also use what's called a map builder. It has got all the weights in terms of the ping latencies that are used to make this decision.
So behind the scenes, you're looking at that client doing the pings based on where they're at.
Exactly. So actually, the client will ping the traffic manager, and the traffic manager returns a suitable service domain name, which client again talks to.
Okay.
So this is the demo one.
That's the first one, performance. That makes sense.
Yeah. So let's move on to the second advantage of the traffic manager, which is, you can use Traffic Manager. Say you got two, let me go back to the slide to show you the configuration here. You got, say you got two services. You know, one is in, don't worry about where it is currently for this demo, but two locations, right? Same service, but you want to make sure that when the first service is taken down for updation, et cetera, you know, the second service should be available for your customer. So that, you know, customers shouldn't see the outage in any way, right?
Right.
You can actually use Traffic Manager to achieve this. How do we do this? Let's go to the traffic, the Azure portal again, and locate the Traffic Manager policies that we created, which is the Edge Perf. Double click on that. You see an endpoint. Both the endpoints are there, right? So you can actually say, assume that for a moment, demo Europe is being upgraded.
Okay.
Okay. You are revving the software version.
Yep. Sure.
So I'm going to disable that, you know, saying that, hey, you know, don't serve customers this particular endpoint anymore, okay, until I'm done.
And that's just disabling the traffic manager from routing it there. It's not obviously disabling the cloud service, right?
Yeah, but okay. It's not visible to the customer at this point. So you can actually play with your stuff.
So once you hit that disable button, are existing clients that are using the Europe one, are they still connected?
They're still connected, but you can wait for demo. I'm not going to wait for it, but you can actually drain them off.
Okay, and how does that work?
That depends on the service. You can actually, you know, configure your service not to accept anymore, or you know, wait until everybody is done.
Okay, so at this point, you would have to now go to that cloud service then to make sure there's nobody still on it.
Correct. That is a service dependent, service specific kind of action that the customer has to take care of.
Okay.
And it's a planned maintenance. Remember, it's not like you know.
Right.
So you can plan ahead of that.
Right.
Right. How to kind of take it down.
Yeah.
Okay. So now we can see that the status is disabled, right?
Yep.
So if we go back to the Europe VM that we had, then I'm going to kill this again so that, you know, just to flush all the DNS caches, go back to private browsing mode so that I can beat all the caching stuff. And hopefully, we should be actually going to US now because I took the Europe service down.
Okay.
Right, so let's see what happens.
There we are, we're in the US. Like magic, hit disable, and there you go. You're now in the US.
Yeah, hopefully you are updating your Europe one. Right?
Okay.
So that's the second use case of Traffic Manager. Right. So let's go back to the third.
So one question related to that. So I mean, obviously, there's a number of ways you can kind of upgrade services, right? I know, particularly with PaaS, right? You can do staging, production, those kinds of things. When would you say that really makes sense to do this, right? As opposed to that option.
This is one of the options that you have. Right. This is a non-invasive, you know. From the user perspective, you know, it is like you need to have multiple services anyway for the sake of disaster recovery.
Right.
So when you have that configuration, you can as well make use of this feature to update also. You don't need yet another kind of capability.
Yeah. Right? So even if you don't have that, even if you're not running PaaS or you're running, let's say, a website behind a VM, perhaps, right, you could now still utilize this failover mechanism.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay. So you've got one more trick up your sleeve, I hear. What's the third scenario here you've got?
So third, let me explain the third scenario and then go back and then fix it for the demo.
Sure. Okay?
So third scenario is disaster recovery, which is an important scenario where you can actually have a primary, secondary kind of service scenario. All your customers will be going to the primary.
Mm-hmm.
And if the primary is down, traffic manager can automatically route your customers to the secondary.
Okay.
Okay. So this is like a fallback kind of scenario, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that can be explained here in this slide, wherein you know what we are doing is we'll be having US as a primary and the Europe as a secondary. If the US site is down, for this we can take down the VM itself, you know, the service itself that is being run. And then see whether the requests are routed to the secondary one.
Okay.
So let's see
that in action. Yeah.
Let me jump back to this. And in order to do this, you need to have the right set of policies created to do this, right?
Okay.
So let me go back to the Traffic Manager dashboard, create yet another policy using Quick Create. I'm going to create load balancing, disaster recovery kind of policy here, which is failover.
Okay. Now, we could also go back into that same policy and choose and configure it
as a failover if
you wanted, right?
Yeah. For the demo, I'm just leaving it there and then, you know.
Sure, yeah.
So I'm going to call it as Edge DR, disaster recovery.
Sure.
Everything else will be same. And when done, I'm also going to configure it with the right set of policies, right? Let's add the endpoints, same two endpoints that we earlier showed, which is demo Europe cloud app.net and demo US cloud app.net.
Mm-hmm.
Register these two endpoints. All right, go back to the configure, just
30 for the demo. Yeah.
30 for the demo. And you can see that the load balancing method is failover.
Yeah.
We can leave it at that. And also please note the DNS name in this case, it's the HDR traffic manager.net. Yep. One of the reasons why I chose separate thing is just to kind of drill down that the disaster recovery kind of policy that we are going to go after. Mm-hmm. And failover priority list, you see an additional menu here saying that which one you want primary and which one should be the secondary here, mm-hmm. right? So it can even be a large list here, you know, in which case it goes one after another, right?
Right.
So I'm going to choose US as the primary, Europe as the secondary.
Okay.
You can choose pretty much what you want. Mm-hmm. Then I'll let the rest of the stuff same and then save the profile.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Each one is called the profile
yeah.
here. All right, so we configured yet another profile called failover profile or disaster recovery profile. We also have the domain name in this case called hdrtrafficmanager.net. So let me show a demo where to simulate certain failure and see whether the traffic is routed to the right endpoint, right? So let me launch in private browsing. And let me see what happens now if I ping HDR traffic manager.net. We should be going where? To US.
Yeah.
Right?
That's right.
That's
yep.
where we are. So now we can simulate the cloud service failure by either taking down the service itself or killing the service.
Yeah.
So let me go back to the dashboard here. So remember that I used two services called Demo US and Demo Europe.
Yep.
So Demo US is the one which is active. That's why you are able to see that
right.
the download point as Demo US. So let's go in here.
And just shut it down.
Shut it down. Let's go to the configure. And in the bottom menu, you got an option to shut it down.
Okay.
Stopped it.
There you go. You're going to stop it. Click
stop
yes.
It.
Yep.
Click yes. And wait for it to stop, really.
Right.
It's that the Azure Fabric is taking down this particular instance of the cloud service. So as it spins down, we can look at, we can go through the other slides that I have to show how the traffic manager actually works, right?
Yeah. So let's see it, right? It's powered down. So let's see what it looks like now.
So to see what is going on behind the scene, mm-hmm. What Traffic Manager is doing is it is trying to ping, you know, using the GET that we talked about.
Right.
So at each of this 30-second interval, it is pinging the services, right? These are the cloud services.
Yep.
Now, what happened was when we killed one of the services to simulate failure, you know, it got into the service offline mode.
Mm-hmm.
Traffic Manager detects that, and then onwards, whatever query that comes from the customer, you know, it directs to the Europe instance in this case, mm-hmm. because that's the policy that we are configuring with.
Okay. So the interval that you have there, you list 5 seconds. Is that a default setting, kind of hard-coded in the background?
This is the probe interval. You know, it takes around like 30 seconds to probe normally.
Okay.
And then when it doesn't get the response, it starts rapid firing. You know,
okay.
5 seconds.
And that's all kind of under the hood, right?
It's all under the hood.
Okay.
Okay.
So then you have what you are able to configure is the DNS TTL.
Got
right?
it.
And so that's where you have that option to, if you lower it, then on that client cache, it's going to now attempt to go to.
It can quickly fail over. If the TTL is longer at the customer side, then customers will still try to reach to the old cloud service, you know,
right.
thereby getting a bad experience. Right?
Right.
So this is one of the DNS-related artifacts that we got to deal with.
Yeah.
Configuring TTL lower for the DR will be much better.
Yeah, because you'll have basically the two IP addresses for the two different services
right.
on the client cache until that cache is
until
expired.
Until it's flashed,
yeah.
it don't see the next one.
Okay, right. I gotcha.
Okay. So let's go back to the Traffic Manager portal and see whether services are really down from the Traffic Manager perspective,
yep.
right? So going back to the TM dashboard, you got DR. Let's see whether endpoints are still, you can see the service is degraded.
Yeah.
Right? So that is the probe at the end of the probe interval.
Is it not up? Oh, you're still seeing that. Okay.
Oh.
So it's the woes of
Windows 8?
No, just a PowerPoint's presentation mode. Okay, so just start.
Okay.
Just start here and say, okay, we're now back in the dashboard, and you can see.
So getting back into the Windows Traffic Manager dashboard, and then we chose the HDR profile. You know, in HDR, you can now see that the demo US cloud service is in the degraded state, you know, because we stopped it, right? So if the customer tries to reach your HDRTrafficManager.net, that request will be routed to the demo Europe.
All right, wow. So we have seen a lot of cool stuff that Traffic Manager can do. You know, disaster recovery, fault tolerance, performance, all kinds of good stuff. Now, of course, I'm sure there are many other scenarios that people can drum up here in their head. What give us the scoop, man. What's coming? What's coming down the pipe here?
Yeah, so there are a lot of things out there, but I can actually share a few of them.
Okay, yeah.
As you could see, you know, we are today monitoring cloud services, right? It's kind of restricted to the cloud services.
Right.
So there are a lot of pent-up demand from our Traffic Manager customers to open it up for non-cloud services, like Antares sites, and also for the non-Azure endpoints. Say they may run their own other endpoints, and then they want to bring those things under the Traffic Manager domain.
Mm-hmm.
So we are working very actively at this stage, and then you know, in FY14, we should be able to see this kind of features out.
Awesome,
As a subsequent to our GA.
Really cool, yeah. I mean, I know with Azure, I mean, you know, we're all just focused on the customer and the customer needs and what people are wanting, so it's cool to hear, give people a little nugget of wisdom out there. So just, you know, keep listening to the Edge Show and you know, you'll get the inside scoop here. Thank you so much for your time. Really appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. All right, hopefully you enjoyed that interview on the Windows Azure Traffic Manager. If you have comments or questions specifically related to that interview, please comment on this interview below. If there are other things that you would like to hear or see from the Edge Show team inside of Microsoft, definitely let us know. You can send us an email, edge@microsoft.com. You can hit us up on Facebook, Channel 9 Edge Show, or you could send us a tweet, @TNEdge.